Now, if he had lived, Keith Moon would have been 70 last month, but his life always seemed destined to be short. Apart from being one of rock's greatest drummers, he was a huge character, a wild party animal, and he remains hugely influential to this day. His story is now being told in a new graphic novel, Who Are You? The Life and Death of Keith Moon. Jim McCarthy is the author. We'll be talking to him in a moment. But first, a little reminder of what made the man who some people called Moon the Loon such an extraordinary performer, with the help of some images from Jim's book. If you think that I don't know about the little tricks you play, and never see you when deliberately put in my way, well, here's a poke at you. You're gonna choke on it too. You're gonna lose that smile, because all the while I can see for miles and miles. I can see for miles. Know what song we're going to have in our head all day today? Jim is with me now, though. Good to have you with us. What
nice
is this ongoing fascination with Keith?
Well, I think Keith was, as you've just seen from that intro there, was a very radical drummer. I mean, he had two lessons with Carla Little, who was the drummer with Screaming Lord Sutch, and he just, from there, just seemed to blossom really quickly as a drummer. He was a very radical drummer in the sense of he played in a sense that was very kind of untrammeled. He played like with Pete Townsend, for example. He didn't play locked into the bass player. So he kind of played in a very kind of crazed style, really. Just created this sheet of sound behind The Who, which made them kind of give him a very renegade edge,
you know,
I thought.
It was that talent as a drummer, but also his private life as well, surely. People are fascinated by it still.
Yeah, I think, you know, I mean, he had kind of 10 years where he burnt very brightly, but obviously he was using vast amount of drugs, and I think alcohol and uppers was his drugs of choice, if you like. But he, you know, I think towards the end, he was obviously starting to get very scared by it and wanted to pull out of that lifestyle, because I think he realized that he was on the way out. He was going to die, you know. I mean, he'd been caning it pretty hard for 10 years. And I think, you know, it affected his family life with his wife, Kim. You know, she left and came back, and then she left, and this time for good. I think that affected him. There was a guy that got run over, a chauffeur that got run over in a car accident.
And he never got over that.
And I think that affected him a lot also, you know, according to people I've spoken to. And, you know, it's a very strange, probably a very strange thing for him being in that kind of environment. It's a very distorted lifestyle anyway, because you've got constantly people kind of kissing your backside, telling you how great you are, and then of course, you've got no kind of rudders. And I think, you know, towards the end, he just tragically took this overdose of heminevrin, which was there to try and taper him off alcohol, you know.
But Jim, those two elements, the fact that he was a talented, incredible drummer and his private life as well. How did those two combine when you were writing the book? Did it actually make it easier for you in a way that he was such a large character?
Yeah, I mean, this book was based on an Omnibus Press, a really good selling book that my editor, David Barraclough, and I had a great conversation. We said we really ought to do a representation because the book has sold so well. And, you know, we wanted to do a graphic retelling of the story, basically. And we did, you know, it's just come out. And it's available on Amazon, Kindle, etc.
And what's the value of doing the book as a sort of graphic novel, do you think?
Well, it's a different way of telling a story. I mean, for me as a writer, I've always been fascinated by comic culture since I was about 10 years old. So when I'm writing these, I'm writing for an audience, but I'm also writing for an artist, because the words in the pictures are totally kind of conjoined, you know. So it's a different way of writing. It's not the same as writing a straight biog in a way. You can do things with the pictures. You know, you can short circuit a lot of stuff, really, that you might need lots of exposition to say, like a page you can do in one panel. You know, you can just say it all very quickly.
Jim, great to have you with us. Well, here is Keith Moon with Roger Daltrey, Pete Townsend and John Entwistle giving us a live performance. We thought it only right that you see him in action. The Who's Long Live Rock on the BBC's Old Grey Whistle Test.